Somebody needs to hear this word this morning. Do you trust that God is for you even when he doesn't give you what you ask for?
Love is love. Love is love. Adios.
Beloved, some of the hardest moments in life are when you prayed hard, you've been persistent, but God has still answered your prayer by saying no. And you may never know why, but that is the litmus test of trust. Do you trust God even when you can't trace him? Do you trust that God is for you even when he doesn't give you what you ask for? Do you trust God that he has a reason beyond your reason? Do you trust that his plan is superior to yours? That God may know better than you how to bring you through? You know it hurts. I know it hurts. I know it hurts, and you don't know why. Your baby boy, your beautiful baby boy, the one you named Elijah, because you wanted him to be a prophet to the nation. Elijah, you prayed over him in the crib. Elijah, you read scriptures to him like nursery rhymes. You just read scriptures to him over and over again. Elijah, you wanted to raise up a prophet. Now Elijah is smoking crack. So you and your husband go on a fast, and you stand against the wiles of the enemy. You stand in agreement, and you prayed, and you cried, and you cried, and you prayed. Yet still, Elijah's on crack. What do you do now? What do you do now? You trained the last four people who eventually became your supervisor. You got your education, you got your training, you got the ability. And they keep passing you up. So you pray to God for direction before going into your boss's office. You've given this company 25 years. 25 years. And you walk in the boss's office and you ask him for a promotion. And you did something all right. You get fired. What do you do now? Your husband takes care of his body. There is a history of heart disease in his family. So he eats right. He runs marathons. He stays in the gym. And then he has a heart attack. Man's not 40 years old. So you fall on your knees and you pray and you cry and you cry and you pray. And then he dies. He doesn't just get worse. He dies. Your first love dies. What do you do now when God says no? How do we answer the unanswerable? Some of the hardest moments in life are when you prayed hard, like we talked about on Wednesday. When you prayed with persistency, like we spoke of on Thursday. But for some reason, God still says no. And you don't know why. And you may never know why. But that's the test of trust. If you fully understand, do you really have a need for trust? Once again, because somebody needs to hear this word this morning. This is not going to be lilacs and daffodils. This is not going to be naming and claiming. Somebody needs to hear this word this morning. Do you trust that God is for you even when he doesn't give you what you ask for? Do you trust he has a plan better than yours? We live in an age of blab it and grab it, name it and claim it. People teach you if you pay your tithes, if you give your tithes, I should say, God will answer your prayer just because you gave your tithe. And the reason we are in these times because, believe it or not, beloved, we are in, by and large, the biblically illiterate generation of believers. People shun the Bible. That's why you hear me say constantly over and over again, the Bible says, the Bible says, the Bible says, because it's in these moments when you're going to need some Bible when you're going through life's most difficult trials. I spend a lot of time, and when I say a lot, I mean a lot of time in prayer. Because I spend more, you better believe it. Boy, you better believe it. But I cherish my times with God. I really do. I spend a lot of time. I spend a lot of time in the Word. And I love talking to Him, and I love Him talking back to me through His Word. I love speaking to Him about my life and the lives of others. And with all of that being said, there are things I don't understand that He does. But it's in these moments that we must all be careful. Follow me. Because if you don't guard your heart, your unresolved anger toward God can undermine your faith. It's like a slow drip, undermining your faith. Drip, 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 undermining your faith. And your faith can affect your walk with God. Sometimes your only option is trust, because it is the last card in your hand. But it's the wild card. Thank you, Holy Ghost. See, and I need you to hear what I'm about to say. See, and this might be the most important sentence I've uttered in the past 21 days. Here we go. If you can trust God when the answer is no, you will give Him the praise He deserves when the answer is yes. If you can just learn to trust God, woo, when He says no, you will give Him the praise He deserves when the answer is yes. When the answer is no, you need to press on and press in. When the answer is no, you need to press in and press on. Press in and press on. Press on and press in. And let God know, God, I still trust you. God, I still trust you. No, I don't understand your ways. But God, my faith in you is even stronger. And I shall still trust God. By definition, praying hard is praying when it's hard to pray. It's praying when it's hard to pray. And it's the hard time that teaches us to pray hard. But if you keep praying through, that peace that transcends understanding will guard your heart and your mind. So you cannot give up with a perceived defeat. It's never defeat when it comes to God, because like Sister Lasagna said, sometimes we know how the story ends. When you read that Bible, you know how the story ends. But you got to pray your way through to the good part. Sometimes the answer to our prayers is no. And you'll never understand why. But here's some good news, beloved. What we perceive as unanswered prayers are only the greatest answer. My God. What we perceive as unanswered prayers are often the greatest answer. You see, our Heavenly Father is far too wise and loves us far too much to give us everything we ask for. Someday we will thank God for the prayers He didn't answer, as much as we thank Him for the prayers He did. But our frustration will turn to celebration if we patiently and persistently pray it through it. Pray through it. It may not make sense for a few years. It may not make sense for the rest of your life. But I take you down this 21-day journey to give you a lesson about unanswered prayers. Sometimes God gets in the way to show us the way. My God. That's your tweet right there. Sometimes God gets in the way just to show us the way. That's your morning tattoo. You're going to the tattoo parlor. Sometimes God gets in the way to show us the way. Need some Bible? Here you go. Thank you, Holy Ghost. One of the craziest miracles in the Bible involves a talking donkey. A talking donkey. No, it was not Eddie Murphy. See, a prophet named Balaam is headed to Moab because he's been offered money just to curse the Israelites. Now, his mind was on his money, and his money was on his mind. And on his way, an angel of the Lord gets in the way. Balaam doesn't even see the angel, but his donkey does. Three times the donkey saved Balaam's life by stomping. But Balaam is infuriated at his dumb donkey. Why? Because his mind was on his money. And his money was on his mind. That's when God opens the donkey's mouth. And the donkey says to Balaam, and please read this when you have some time. It's in Numbers 22, right around verse 21. 22 and 21. The donkey says, "What have I done to you to make you beat me these three times?" And Balaam responds to his donkey now that saved his life is this. He says, you made a fool out of me. If only I had a sword in my hand, I'd kill you right now. Now, let me slow drag this thing for a moment. And then we're going to pray. In all fairness, I don't know how anybody will react if one of your pets start talking to you. But Balaam is so enraged because he has his mind on his money and his money on his mind. Get this. He's so focused on his plan that he's not thinking straight. God saying no saves his life thrice, but he's not thinking straight. You see, if you've got a talking donkey on your hands, the last thing you need to worry about is some little money. The last thing you need to think about is killing it. So you need to find yourself an agent. You need to get a movie deal and sell the movie rights to this story. You need to go to Vegas. But here's where I'm taking you, because he focused on what he wanted. He totally missed the miracle right in front of him. Drop the mic. Thank you, Holy Ghost. When God fails to answer a prayer, look for a miracle right in front of your eyes. When a prayer is not answered, be bold enough to ask God, "God, what are you saying in this moment? God, what are you saying in the moment? I lost my best friend, and it hurts. They died in a car crash. I love you, God. But God, what are you saying in this moment? I lost my job, and it hurts. I got this disease, and it hurts. But God, what are you saying in this moment? God, to the God who controls all and knows all. God, what are you saying to me in this moment?" All of us love miracles. We don't like to be in a situation where we need a miracle. See, we hate finding ourselves between an Egyptian army and a Red Sea. But this is how God reveals his glory. This is how God reveals his power. This is how God reveals his majesty. We want, thank you, Holy Ghost. We want, thank you, Holy Ghost. We want God to part the Red Sea while the Egyptian army is still in Egypt. We want God to provide for our needs before we even need it. But sometimes, baby girl, God waits. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Sometimes God waits. Thank God for a God that waits. Thank God for a God that waits. Thank God for a God that waits, because waiting develops trust. At first, the Israelites can see a dust cloud in the distance, and God waited longer. And they can hear the hooves of the horses and the wheels of their chariots, and God waited longer. And then they're so close that they can recognize the faces of their slave masters, and God waited longer. The Israelites are sitting ducks, and God is the one that led them to this place, and he waits, and he waits, and he waits, and he waits. Sometimes God would lead us to a place where we have nowhere to turn but to him. Our only option is to trust him. When our back is against the wall and it looks as if it was over, he'll make a way where there was no way. He becomes an option when there are no other options. But let me share one thing with you that can turn your life around. And then we're going to pray, I promise you. No matter what the unanswered prayer is, no matter what you've been going through, this passage right here will change your life. No matter how dark the night, no matter what questions you may have, this passage here will bless you. I assure you. This scripture right here will give you hope. It will give you hope when you got no peace in your heart, when life gives you the most unanswerable questions. God says, and as thy days, so shall thy strength be. As thy days are, so shall thy strength be. My God, my God, my God. What God is saying in this B clause of Deuteronomy 33 is this. Just keep living. Because I've given you strength to get through that day. I don't know about you, but that thing did it for me. The fact that you're still here today, God is saying you got enough strength to get through today. Just keep breathing. Just keep believing. Just keep receiving. Just keep breathing. Just keep believing and keep receiving, because God is saying, I've given you the strength to move past that valley. I've given you the strength to cross through that path. The tougher the day, the greater the strength. The harder the test, the greater the power. The more complicated the problem, the more calming the God. God will give you the strength to get through, even when he says no. As thy days are, so shall thy strength be. When that prayer is not answered, let me share something with you, baby girl. Let me talk to you, baby boy. Come closer. You're strong enough to get through it. It might hurt you to your core, but you're strong enough to get through it. It might hurt you, but you're strong enough to get through it. No matter what happens in life, as thy days are, so shall thy strength be. As thy days are, so shall thy strength be. As thy days are, so shall thy strength be. As thy days are, so shall thy strength be.
Hey, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so we can share with you new content from First Day Christian Center. And if you like what you watch, give us a thumbs up so we can share the word with others. Thank you so very much for watching. Be blessed. I love you. Bye-bye.